Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could.
Hi, guys. This is Linda. And it's not very often that the First Nations or Native Americans will call something a false flag or even say, please join us in this fight. But the Mohawks are asking, and I'd like to read their article from the Mohawk Nation News. And please listen carefully to what these empire globalist bankers have to say. Hold on. This is called Whistle Stop Terror. This was put out July 12, 2013. The blowing up of the train bomb in Megantic, Quebec, raised false flag questions. This event shows the destructive relationship between the corporation and the community created by the government through deregulation. The train went from Montreal, then through the Mohawk community of the Kahnawake at their junction station, and then on to Megantic. Ed Bernhardt of Chicago is the CEO of Montreal, Maine and Atlantic Railroad Company. He also owns the tracks and the trains of international conglomerate Rail World in Australia, New Zealand, Britain, Estonia, Poland, Ukraine, Canada, and U.S. These cars carry mostly deadly war materials in thin, easily punctured tankers. 12.5% of the shareholders in the rail company is the Caisse de Dépôt et Placement du Québec. I don't speak French well, sorry. The Public Sector Pension and Insurance Fund. Bernhardt is blaming a lone gunman, Tom Hayden, for not following regulations that don't exist, by the way. To make a 2% profit, trains are left unattended. Jovial Bernhardt joked about having to wear a bulletproof vest to meet the horrified survivors of the bombing. He kept apologizing, sorry, 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 he told the Wall Street Journal, that not enough manual handbrakes were applied to the train before it was left unattended. We don't really have a performance standard to measure all our staff against. They don't even have a performance standard measure. They have no regulations, is what he's saying. He told the Montreal Gazette his company is not at fault. He blamed the firefighters who put out the blaze of one locomotive. He is thinking of transferring the crew to Cherbourg, 100 miles away. On Saturday, July 6th, the train smacked into the packed gathering place in the center of town, wiping out most of the youth of the village. They were having a beer on a hot summer night. Burkhart announced that the company intends to keep running freight through Megantic. Later, we'll clean up all the wrecked cars and rebuild tracks around the town and start to run the trains through here again. And I know that there was a pristine water, a lake, I believe, there, and they're not going to even mention that. But I'll finish with this. They just speed through the center of town like Kahnawake. The problem is that Megantic, like Kahnawake, don't need trains for passengers, delivery, or pickup. The American Association of Railroads says that it cost $1 to $3 million to build a mile of mainline rail. The oil comes from North Dakota, Saskatchewan, and Alberta. These are the tar sand oils. You guys know that, right? The rail barons and their accomplices deliver their goods to the East and West Coast for international distribution. Train companies are private businesses and are exempt from municipal regulations and noise bylaws. Railways are responsible to themselves only, their own inspections with no obligations to inform anybody about hazardous materials like oil, ethanol, sulfuric acid, or propane they carry through our villages, rural land is cheaper without restriction. The government gave all our land away, no charge, to the rail companies, without our knowledge or consent. They do not own it. It is one of the last vestiges of colonialism. These rail families made their fortune originally in the opium trade in China. They are the pirates of the Caribbean, the bankers who continue to terrorize the world. The people of Magantique will never forget the lost ones. As Hank Snow reminds us, never speak harsh words to your dear loving husband. He may leave you and never return. And that was the wreck of the old 97. An objection has been launched for these illegal forays over our land, threatening our lives. The Council of Great Peace is being violated. The people of Lac Magantic and others may follow the roots and sit in protection of the shade of the Great Tree of Peace. We have been waiting for all of the people to join us. And that is spectacular. Now, I would like to tell you, First Nations is asking the private people of Canada, you that are under the same problems they're having, please join them and hold them accountable. And here in America, the Native Americans have been asking the regular Americans, please join us in our battle for what is going on, for what they are doing to the earth. And I think that this is such a just an outstanding statement from the Mohawk Nation, asking everyone to join them. And I am from the Turtle Island Clan, not the Mohawk Nation. And I am asking everybody, please join us. We need to save Mother Earth and North America from these pirates of the Caribbean. And I love you all. Peace, love, and truth, always. Please leave your comments below. Linda's out.